The red carpet has now become the leading showcase for all the designers, the jewelers, the hairstylists, the makeup artists. Do you know it takes so many people to get the celebrities ready for the big night that it's almost as intriguing as the entrance itself? I'm here in London on one of the most expensive streets in the world. It's Bond Street. We've passed Asprey, Tiffany, Van Cleef & Arpels, and also Cartier. They all have exclusive stores here. And maybe in one or two of those stores, you have De Beers diamonds that have been rough mined there. But for the first time only, tonight, we have the grand opening of the De Beers flagship store, where we're gonna see exclusive designs and jewelry from De Beers. Follow me. It's coming up to the 75th anniversary of the Oscars, which means that more than ever, the emphasis is going to be on diamonds, diamonds, diamonds. And to tell me just why is leading diamond expert Joan Parker.
Well, about 30 years ago, I started doing publicity for diamonds. And in those days, celebrities were not the top thing that we did. We were getting diamonds in magazines and getting stories on them. And then all of a sudden, Hollywood was discovered. And the fact, of course, that getting celebrities and getting them on the red carpet seemed to be the best way to get things in the media. So I'd say for the last 20 years, we've been looking at dressing celebrities in diamonds.
I believe De Beers have been mining for about 110 years. So why has it taken so long for them to open their first ever store?
Well, it's so interesting that people have always thought that there's a De Beers product out there. De Beers company that you know has only mined rough diamonds and sold rough diamonds. There's never been De Beers Diamond Jewelry until now. And this is a completely new company that is owned half by De Beers and half by LVMH. And it's the first time that you've been able to go into a store and actually buy a piece of De Beers jewelry.
So Joan, tell me about the Millennium Star. It's been much publicized. How do you gauge its value and why is it so priceless?
Well, I mean, as I said, the value is it's priceless. And it's 203 carats, pear-shaped, internally and externally flawless diamond, and it's the only one in the world. So how do you put a price on that? I mean, some people have quoted it at $100 million, some people have quoted it a little over $50 million, but nobody really knows the price.
Iman was wearing the De Beers diamond at the Cannes Film Festival, got so much press about it. Can you tell me who will be wearing it this year at the Oscars on that red carpet?
Well, you know, we never say who's going to be wearing the Millennium Star for security reasons. Even when Iman wore it, until she walked down the red carpet, nobody knew that she was going to have it on. So this year, we hope to have one of the nominees wearing it. We'll never tell anybody who, but I'll tell you one thing. She has to have a good cleavage if she's going to wear it. And so we'll find somebody, the right person for it.
Of course, Elizabeth Taylor had a phenomenal collection of diamonds, her own diamonds. But most celebrities, they borrow their diamonds, don't they?
Yes, that's true, I think, except there's certain celebrities that have a lot of diamonds, like Oprah Winfrey always wears her own diamonds. But I think the reason is that the big diamonds, most people don't have a collection of large diamond necklaces and earrings and they want to change what they wear. They may have, you know, something very wearable, but when they're dressing up for the red carpet, they want something big and they want to look different all the time. So they don't have that kind of a wardrobe, but most of them have diamonds of their own, but they may be the smaller diamonds that you'd see that they'd wear every day.
This is really the epitome of the De Beers brand and was inspired by the leather necklaces that are worn by African the tribes people, which are supposed to really instill power and strength and sensuality into the person.
You can't be at a De Beers party without diamonds.
Here's my diamond, here he is. He gave this to us tonight. Our own little diamond. I don't know how many carats that is.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That was given to all the guests.
Well, it was very interesting. About 1990, you all of a sudden saw all these necklaces. And in fact, People magazine put on the front cover that year, it's all the Oscars, it's all about diamonds and cleavage. And it was, and everybody was wearing these big necklaces. And the big necklaces were very popular then for about 5 years. And I'd say only recently, actually, have you noticed some people getting away from big necklaces. Some people like Nicole Kidman always wears a big necklace and a few people like that. But basically, also a lot now have gone for earrings, big earrings, like the ones I have on. And you saw a lot at the last Oscars. You saw a lot of big earrings like this. And they were earrings became very popular in the past 2 years. And bracelets have had their popularity coming down the runways as well. And I think this year, you're actually going to see a little of everything. It's going to be very eclectic.
Which brands are we going to see on the red carpet this year?
Well, it's interesting. You know, years ago, the game belonged to Harry Winston, I'd say, when they started out. Now, everybody is there. I mean, you would find in every Oscars, you'll see Asprey out there, you'll see Harry Winston, you'll see Fred Layton, you'll see Neil Lane, you'll see Martin Katz, you'll see Van Cleef & Arpels. Everybody is, H. Stern. I mean, everybody's out there giving their diamonds to celebrities. And this year, what will be really new and different is there's a new brand now. And so De Beers will be out there for the very first time with their own jewelry. Well, you can only go by past experience that you know. Like, we know Halle Berry will be a presenter for Best Actress. Last year, she wore a pumpkin-colored ring and very small, dainty earrings. And she doesn't like to wear big necklaces. So I'm sure that this year you'll see the same thing. I mean, I think she'll be wearing something very discreet. Then you go with the stars that like, you know, more jazzy kind of jewelry. And, I mean, Nicole Kidman likes antique. You always see her in kind of an antique look. And I think what you're going to see this year, as I said, is going to be very eclectic. I think you're going to see a little of everything. But, I mean, people are talking about who the nominees are, all right? And they're saying, well, that it may be Catherine Zeta-Jones in Chicago, and it may be Selma Hayek in her last movie, and Julianne Moore. And each one of them has their own style. But I think all three of those actually could go with big necklaces. That's what we may see. Well, I think what's going to happen with diamonds is you're going to see more casual, like you've seen here in this store, leather and diamonds, which is kind of unique. And I think what else you're going to see is interesting is diamonds don't have to be a gift of love. You're going to see women buying their own diamonds, just like they buy expensive shoes, they buy expensive handbags, they buy designer dresses. There's no reason why they can't afford a piece of diamond jewelry.
I buy all my own diamonds. I've never asked a man for anything.
Well, I think the focus is far too much on women, so I'm going to go and see what I can buy. Thank you, Joan. I'm going to bling bling when I leave
this
place.
Don't get a ring, a diamond ring.
Thank you.